Rock Compare. Let's have a look at its definition. It says, this compares the contents of two SAS datasets, selected variables in different datasets, or variables within the same datasets. Meaning, you can do three of the things. Either you can compare two datasets, or you can compare two full datasets. Either you can compare two full datasets, or you can compare selected variable from two datasets, or you can compare some specific variable within the same dataset. Alright. So this is why we use the proc compare. Let's see what all are the elements which we can compare using the proc compare procedure. So we can compare number of variables and observation in both of the datasets. We can compare values in the matching variables are same or not. Meaning, let's say if we have variable A in two datasets, and if we want to see whether those two variables have same value or not, that we can also do over here. Next, variables in common and different. We can find out whether what all are the variables which are common in two datasets and what all are the variables which are different in two datasets. We can check out the attributes of matching variables. Let's say if there is a variable X in table 1 and the same variable is in table 2, and if we want to check whether both of these two variables have same attribute, means data type, length, etc. or not, then we can also do that using the proc compare procedure. Now, because we have understood that what all are the elements which we can compare using the proc compare, but what are the situations when we actually need to compare two tables? Because if we have two data sets which are same in shape and size, then why do we have to compare that? Well, then to answer this, we have couple of things. We do that in case of migration. For example, suppose in current time your company has your holds the data or DWH on Oracle, but some migration happens and the data is moved on another system, let's say Hadoop. Then in that scenario, you have to make the changes in queries, and in that case, you have to check whether the data set moved on the new source is same as the data set which was available on older source or not. In that scenario, you would require to use the proc compare to see the structure of both of the two data sets. Then it comes to change in codes. For example, you have some manual codes, and if you want to automate that using macros, then after automating that, you would like to see whether the output which is coming out from the automated macro is same as the older one or not. In that scenario, you can use proc compare. Then you can create a validation report. As we just saw, we would require to compare the tables in two scenarios, and now because you have done the comparison using proc compare, you can easily prepare the validation report. If you are making some changes in the data, then you can in that scenario also you would require to compare two tables, and in that case also you can use proc compare. So these all were the reasons when we require to compare two tables. So now we will see what all are the points which we're gonna cover in this series. So how all we're gonna use proc compares. First, we will see how can we do the basic comparison of two data sets. Then we will take it to the advanced level, and we would see how we can compare two data sets based on either one or multiple ID variables. Then we will see how we can compare dataset attributes only, right? And then we will see how we can compare datasets by observations, and then we will see how we can compare variables in the same dataset, means in one dataset how we can compare the different variables. So welcome to the channel. To understand the concept very clearly, please watch the video till the end. Once you are done with watching the video, do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. So first thing which we're going to learn today is basic comparison of two data sets. How we can do the basic comparison of two data sets. For that, we have one table which is car summary. This has 14 observations, and if you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 variables. We have second data set which is named as car summary 2, and this has 15th observation and 5 variables. Now let's see what are the difference in these two data sets. First difference which you can see is number of observations. In the first table there are only 14 observations, and in second these are 15. Second thing you can notice, first table has 6 variables, in which invoice per unit is the additional variable which is not available in the second table. Next thing you can see, for the third observation, number of unit is 10 in the first table while it's 11 in the second table. Similarly, there are many other differences which we will see using the proc compare. So let's go ahead and try to use these things. To compare two data sets, we don't have to do much. Simply, we will write the procedure proc compare, and this is the statement where we base. It says what is the base data against which you want to compare the another table. So first table you need to provide with base, and then second table you need to provide with compare. So you are saying SAS, this is the base table against which I want to compare this table. Alright, so two elements we use in basic comparison with proc compare. One is base and the other one is compare. So in base you need to provide the older table, and in compare you need to provide the second table which you want to compare. The second table which you produced after making the changes, right? So this is how we write the proc compare syntax. It's very simple. Now let's see what output do we get. When you write this sort of syntax, you get this complete report, right? So there will be 5 sections in your report in basic comparison, and each of them we're gonna study in detail. Let's have a look on the first section. The first section is data set summary. This will provide you the data set summary. What summary it provides? Data set name, on what date it was created, on what date it was modified, how many numbers of variables are there, how many number of observations are there. So data set name, first car summary, it was created on this date, it was modified on this date, and number of variables in this table, car summary table, are 6, and the number of observations are 14, we just saw in the previous slide. Now second table which we have is car summary. This was created and modified on this date. The number of variables it has is 5, and then the number of observations which it has is 15. Alright, so this is the first section of your proc compare procedure, which provides you the summary of data set. Now let's see the second section. In the second section, it tells you all about variables, means it provides you the summary of variables. So it says number of variables in common 5, means in both of the data sets, in one data set there were 6 variables and in second there were 5 variables. So 5 variables were common in both of these two. Number of variables in cars summary, but not in car summary 2. There was one variable which was available in car summary, which is first data, but that was not available in second table. You can see how comprehensive information we are getting over here. If we don't have proc compare processor, it will be quite tedious and cumbersome activity to get all of the details. All right. So this is how you get the variable summary. Now let's see what is the next section. The next section provides you the value comparison summary. It compares the value and provides you a summary. If you can see, all variables compared have let's go one by one. First over here, number of variables compared with all observations equal. means there are no variable which has all observations equal. That's quite obvious. If number of observations are different, none of the variable would have equal value. Then number of variables compared with some observations unequal, 5. Then total number of values which compare unequal, 29. There are 29 values which are unequal in nature. Don't get confused with number of observations and the value. All right. Let's say if there is one variable and it has many observations and this observations are not equal, then that will be counted as 2. Though it has 1, 2, 3, 4 observations, but the number of values unequal would be only 2. All right. So this is why you see the differences in number of unequal values and in number of observations. Don't get confused with that. Now here, and here it says maximum difference is this much. So if you have some numeric variable, then the maximum difference which you are getting in numeric variable is this. So by looking at this, if you get this difference something like 0.5 or something, then you can see and you can consider that it's a silly difference that is considerable. You don't have to worry about much. But if you see this difference is quite huge, so you have to be concerned about it. Now you would require to see the things in detail. All right. So next we have all variables compared have unequal value. Here it provides you a list of only those variables which have unequal values. So if you see type, origin, number of units, total invoice and average MSRP. So all of the 5 variables are listed over here. As I said, let's say if there are 5 variables and if one observation is unequal, like here 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the value, and in the second table you have value for the same observation 5, 6, 7, 8, means in that scenario all of these 4 variables does not have same value available. All right, so this is why it gives you all the 5 variables, though there is a difference in one, just in one observation, but it gives you all the 4 variables. So see, in type variables there are 3 number of differences, in origin variable there are 6 number of differences, and same follows for the next variable. These three variables are numeric. So you can see here the maximum difference. The number of unit, in the number of unit variable, there are say 7 differences, but the maximum difference comes is 14. All right. In total invoices, there are 7 differences, but the maximum difference comes this. So this can become a huge concern for you. This could be still considerable, but it can not be considerable because these are number of units, right? So this can also be a concern for you. So this is how you get the summary of values comparison in this sections. Now let's see in the next section what do we get. In the next section we have observations summary. In previous section we saw variable summary, and next section we have observation summary. So here you can see first observation in both of the table, first observation start at 1, and the first unequal value it finds at third. So the third observation in the first table and third observation in the second table are not same. This is what it wants to say over here. The last observation which are unequal at 14th number, 14th observation, from 3rd to 14th, these observations are not same in both of these two tables. Then it comes to last match. Last match it finds at 14th. Last observation it finds at 15th in the compare table. In the base table, it ends at 14th. You can see at 15th it is missing. Alright. Now let's look at the observation. Number of observations in common 14. Because in one table there were 14 observations, in second there were 15, so common observation will be 14. Number of observations in this table, number of observations in car summary 2, but not in car summary. There is one observation which is available in car summary 2, but that's not in car summary 1. You can see. Then number of observations read from this table are 14. Number of observations read from this table are 15, which we just saw over here. Alright. Then it comes to number of observations with some compared values unequal. There are 8 observations which has unequal value. There are 6 observations which has equal value. So in this section we get the summary of observations. Hope this is this was clear to you. In case if you have doubt, don't hesitate to put your doubt in comment section. In the next we have value comparison results of variables. Alright, so here you get the variables and you get the value which are different. So here you can see it provides you the comparison for type. So in base table for the type variable, in 10th, 12th and 13th number observation you are getting this value, and for type variable in this number of observation, 10th number, 12th number and 13th number, you are getting this value, which are not the same. That's why it has been highlighted over here. Same follows for origin. You can see here for 9th the origin in USA, but here it's Europe. Here it's Asia, but here it's South Africa. And same follows for the next tables, sorry, next variable. If you can see here, it's for total invoice over here, total invoice variable in base table and in compare table. So same it follows for the till the last variable. So the last variable was number of units, and you can see for third number observation in base table the number of unit was 10 while it is 11 in the compare table. So this is how you get the comprehensive information in a basic comparison. Now this was a lot of information which you may not like to have all the time. So as we progress, we will see how we can make it specific to our requirement. Alright. Now let's see. If you have any kind of doubt, please do not hesitate to put your doubt in the comment section. We will definitely get back to you and try to solve your problem. Thank you very much for watching the video. Wish you very good luck.